Welcome back, students. So today we'll be starting. Today we'll be continuing our discussion with ellipse generation. Previously, we have already seen our algorithms for line generations and circle generations. So in this class, we will be seeing how to generate an ellipse. So as we know, an ellipse is something like this, which has major axis and minor axis. The longer one, so we can call major axis as X and we can call minor axis as Y. What is the basic difference between the major axis and minor axis is that X would be greater than Y. So if I have X equal to Y, then what would happen? If I have my major axis is equal to minor axis, that means I will be having a circle. I will be having a circle and both will be equal to the radius of the circle. So we will be seeing what is the how do we generate the ellipse on our computer graphics screen, which is divided into pixels. We have seen how do we generate a circle. So our algorithm is very much simple. How did we generate the circle? In the same way, we will be seeing how my ellipses will be drawn on this computer graphic screen. So let us see few properties of this ellipse before we move on. Basically, an ellipse is a set of points which has, in which each of the point have equal distance if I take any of those two points. Let's say if I have a point P1 and if I have a point P2 anywhere within the boundary of this ellipse. Let's say this is my X1 comma Y1. And here this P2 has X2 comma Y2 and I have this point, let's say P, which has coordinates X and Y, and this P is on the boundary of ellipse. So what is the property of ellipse? That let's say the distance between P1 and P is known as D1 and the distance between P and P2 is known as D2. That means D1 plus D2 is equal to constant. How? So how this is a property? So what I can do, I can keep my P1 and P2 as fixed points and I can keep rotating my P1 to anywhere on the boundary. So in this case, even if it is like this, let's say I am keeping my P1 and P2 as constants. I am not moving their location of P1 and P2 and I am taking now this point. Let's say this is my P dash and these distances are again D1 dash is equal to D2 dash. Then again, this constant is equal to D1 dash plus D2 dash. Means the summation of these distances D1 and D2 is not going to change no matter wherever I move this point P, provided I am keeping these P1 and P2 as my points fixed within the ellipses. What would be the equation of D1 and D2? What is the equation? It would be X minus X1 square plus Y minus Y1 square plus, what will be for the D2? X minus X2 square plus Y minus Y2 square is equal to any constant, or constant means which is the summation of these two distances. So this is a formula to find out the distance d1. This is a formula, as we have already studied, to find out the distance between p2 and p, known as d2. The summation of both the things will be constant. So this is a property of ellipse through which I can find out the points. Now by this algorithm, by this equation, how I can draw my ellipse. Let's say if any ellipse is given and I am given these two points p1 and p2, and I am given only one point as p. So I have three points as an input. One is a p1, which is x1, y1, and I am given another point, which is p2, x2, y2, and I am given another point, which is as px, y, which is on my ellipse. Then how can I do it? I can put all these three points into this equation. Let's say I am calling this equation number 1. I am putting all these three points into this equation and I am finding my constant. Let's say I found out this constant and it is evaluated as, let's say, 20. Let's say this constant, I was given some values and I evaluated this constant as 20. Now, how do I find other points? I can find out other points. I have x minus x1. I have this equation only. So what I can do? I can keep my p1 and p2 as fixed and I can compute my x and y. So what is known here? This thing is known, this thing is known, x2 is known, y2 is known, and I have my constant is also known, let's say as 20. Now what I have to do? I just have to find an x, I just have to put an x and I have to find out a value of y such that it evaluates to 20. So if I can find out, pairs of x and y, which if I put in this equation will evaluate to a constant as 20. So this is how I can find out all my points on the ellipses. But we know it will take lot of time. How it is going to take lot of time? Let's say I considered my x as 5, and I have to now compute y such that it is going to give me this constant value. So what will happen? What I have to do? I have to just solve this equation. I have to take the square root. I have to solve this equation, and every time I have to find out a y, which will take a lot of time in terms of computations, taking square root, doing a float time division or multiplication. So this is why it will take a lot of time, but we will get all the coordinates of the ellipse and we can just draw it. Now we will be seeing other methods to do it more faster. So this was one of the method which we had solved using one of the property of the ellipses. Let's go over other properties of the ellipses and see how we can solve it. Okay, so how we can solve it in other ways, let us understand. We have discussed ellipse has a major axis, which is, let's say, this thing is known as x, and we have a minor axis which is known as y. If I am calling it as a major axis x, that means my x should be greater than y. Okay, now I am seeing where these minor axis and major axis coincides or meets. It is called the center of the ellipse, which as of now is at what location? 0, 0. But this is not always the case, and my ellipse could be like this also, where I have a major axis and minor axis, and this is, let's say, some position 4, 5. This coordinate is somewhere, let's say, 4, 5. So my ellipse need not to be necessarily at the central position. It could be anywhere on the XY plane. And this is this type of ellipses which has their major axis and minor axis aligned with Y axis and X axis respectively are known as standard ellipses. These are known as standard ellipses, where what could happen, I can have a rotated ellipses like this, I can have my ellipses like this, which may have their major axis and minor axis which is not in parallel with X axis and the Y axis. These are called my rotated ellipses, where they are having some degree, some where they are their major axis X, let's say, is having some inclination theta with respect to my normal my X axis. In a similar way, my Y axis can also be having on some phi. So that means it is having some theta. Okay, so these are all called rotated ellipses, and these are all called standard ellipses, which have their major and minor axis aligned with their with the X axis and the Y axis of the coordinate system. So for this ellipse which doesn't have its center, let's define a proper ellipse here. We have, let's say, coordinates as xc comma yc. I am calling these coordinates as xc comma yc, and I am calling my major axis as rx, and I am calling my minor axis as ry, provided rx is greater than ry. Okay, what would be the equation of the ellipse? The equation of the ellipse in this case would be x minus xc upon rx square plus y minus yc upon ry whole square is equal to 1. So this is my equation for the ellipse which is not centered at 0, 0. Now let's see, my ellipse is centered at 0, 0. Let's put the coordinate. If I put the coordinate, it would be x upon rx square plus y square upon ry square is equal to 1. So we get the same thing here. So this is a standard ellipse equation which can be used for anywhere. Correct? So this was the one way of, so we discussed little bit earlier, we discussed one algorithm to find out the points of the ellipses. Now let's say, now we have to find out the points in such cases. What I can do, I can just put x and y here. I know the values of rx, I know the values of ry, I know this constant remains as 1. I can just put the values of x and y such that it is giving me as a result as 1, means it is satisfying the equation, and I can find out all the points on a ellipse. So if my ellipse is not centered at 0, 0, I can use this equation. If my ellipse is centered at 0, 0, I can just use this equation to find out all the points on the ellipse, and then I can just redraw an ellipse.